Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Catenae Innovation has announced that its subsidiary, Hyperneph, has developed a cloud-based platform and a mobile app now used by a charity working with public sector organisations. The agreement is for a period of up to 12 months and is currently on trial in a major UK city. Well, to explain the significance of all of this, I've got Guy Meyer. So great to see you, Guy. How are you?
Very well, thanks, Katie. Very well. Bit of a lousy day today, isn't it, really?
It's pretty grim. Yeah. It's pretty grim. Let's see if we can cheer everybody up with your news. And maybe just give us some background on this pilot programme, if you would, and what it means for Catenae.
Yeah, thank you. Of course, but there's only so much I can say, given the confidentiality agreements we have in place and the sensitivity of the project. But it stems from a lot of work that Hyperneph have been doing with this client in advance of our acquisition of them a few months back. And it also dovetails very nicely into our existing tech platforms. Mm-hmm. So it's sort of and part of it also really is the ability to scale. You know, this is the first of new opportunities for us not post-COVID, because COVID's actually going to be with us for forever, really. The fact of it is really during the pandemic, we've been working on our technology, making sure that it's fit for purpose for in other sectors. And the part of the strategy was to, with the acquisition of Hyperneph, was to actually enhance and build and strengthen the business, et cetera, as I previously said. So it really is the key one here is the first one. It's got a potential to scale. The alerts, it's based on a local authority model. There are lots of local authorities across the country. And so it has that that scalability, really. It's in essence, it's a cookie cutter model. It's developed. We can get the proof of concept and the pilot successful, then it certainly can roll out across the rest of the UK. So that's very exciting.
Very much so. Ability to scale, that's kind of the key takeaway there. In regards to Catenae the group, so you're providing software for these in the public sector. Maybe explain more of how we can expect more of this in the future, because you mentioned the local authorities.
Yeah. So, well, Catenae, we exist. One of our clients is Child and Athletic Community Trust in South East London. We've been working with them for many, many years, and they provide services to Greenwich Borough for youth services. And our tech platform is used by Charlton on behalf of Greenwich, and they produce reports every quarter for stakeholders, etc. And again, during the pandemic, we've been working closely with them, taking feedback from them, enhancing the platform and the apps that they use. And again, those apps that we've developed there can actually be used elsewhere as well. So it really is, you know, go back to this new announcement, albeit small, it is the first proof that actually what we've been doing during the pandemic is the right strategy, keeping an eye on COVID, very much so. We put a lot of our effort into acquiring, looking for business, acquiring pilots with various businesses. And in fact, some of those companies we worked with, one in particular, Critical Infrastructure, again, we're not allowed to actually mention who they are, but that was announced months back, and we gained experience and knowledge, and again enhanced our technology so that it's fit for purpose. And so we now are in a very, very strong position as a business. I know our accounts, an annual report was announced recently, but we've got a lot of financial resources in the bank. We spend our money very wisely. And so we're in a good place, really.
And can you maybe comment on which other key sectors you're targeting?
Yeah, well, the business really is looking at opportunities, and we are in discussions in various sectors, but opportunities where there's long-term annuity income potential. And, you know, so if we look at construction and we look at critical infrastructure, we look at highways, we look at rail, etc., a lot of those contracts, particularly in highways, we know that they run for 30 years plus. And when they were awarded, some of them were, you know, awarded 20, 25 years ago. When they were awarded, paper was and still is largely the method by which information is gathered and then disseminated and stored and reported, etc. And our strategy is to work with digital transformation with businesses. And so that's where we're going to be. All our focus is on now. And, you know, without saying too much, we have some news down the line that's going to be quite exciting. It certainly is for us as a business. And that really is about digital transformation. It really is looking at everything being on screen, everything being mobile, everything being instant reporting, instant access, wherever you are in the world. And our business is a lot about remote working. And mm-hmm. so our team are remote around the country. Yes, we're coming to London and then actually into Newcastle to meet physically, but that's part of our concern for our employees and staff and everyone who works freelance for the business is their health is paramount to us and to them as well. And that reflects companies generally through the UK. We are focusing on health and safety and security. And a part of that is, Katie, we just to remind you and others, is that we spent a lot of time putting effort into getting an ISO 27001 accreditation. And that's all about data management. It's ensuring that we adhere to the UK's GDPR legislation and the regulations around that. But data and the security of data is actually at the core of everything we do. So it's exciting times ahead.
Good stuff. Well, you've got some news coming around the corner, so I'm sure we'll be catching up very soon on the specifics of that you mentioned, Guy Meyer. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Katie. Yeah.
Innovations.
Have a good day. Thanks. Bye.